Hey everybody, what is up? Razirek here, and welcome to my brand new YouTube channel. I decided to put this together because there's a lot of tutorial channels out there for Roblox, but I feel a lot of them assume a little bit too much experience. They kind of take the approach that you have already become familiar with Roblox Studio and take on a little bit more of an advanced approach and don't really cover the bare basics. So I'm going to take the opposite approach and start from the very beginning and sort of progress our way forward. So if you subscribe and keep following along the series, then as we go along, we'll get a little bit more advanced and more detailed and ultimately, hopefully, put together a working game of your own. So now the more visibility this channel gets, the more I will produce. So do me a favor and mash that like and subscribe button and comment on any videos that you see, and I will try to keep track and comment back right back to you. So anyway, this first video is going to be a bit of an introduction to Roblox Studio itself. And some of the modeling tools and how to use the interface and things like that. We'll get into scripting and things like that a little bit later. So to start, I've got Roblox Studio open here. I'm gonna go ahead and open up the Baseplate template. And what this is basically just a blank slate. Nothing really fancy going on here. It's just sort of I guess a Lego block kind of set up here. Just gives you a little platform to build all of your stuff on. Now you can adjust this. You can change this up, remove this, replace it with flat terrain, or if you really want to get tricky, you can go for the terrain creator. We'll get into all of that in later videos, but for now we're going to go ahead and start with the base plate and just sort of walk through some of the toolbars and using the studio itself. So first thing you're going to notice here, this is our camera view, right? So this just kind of gives us a way to check out our workspace and the things that we're building. If you hold the right click, the right mouse button and move around, it lets you control the camera. Scroll wheel lets you zoom in and out. And then you also have keyboard controls, so W, A, S, and D. Kind of move around, and then Q and E go up and down, and you'll find yourself using a combination of the two as you're manipulating your builds and moving around and getting a good view so that you can work more efficiently. These controls that you see here, if you've never worked in a 3D modeler before, there are three axes. All right, so there's the X, Y, and the Z. X is what you see here in this red arrow, which in this particular view is left to right. Z is blue, which is forward and backward, kind of your depth from the camera. And Y is vertical, which you can see if I move a little bit more here. So this green arrow is your Y-axis, and that's going to be your up and down, your vertical axis. And that's all going to be important as you start placing objects and aligning things and moving things around the scene. So to get started, let's go ahead and drop a part. And you can do that here in the Home tab. Just click on Part here. And we get this little Lego piece here. All right. And you'll see it appears over here in our Explorer underneath Workspace. Now, Workspace is where everything that you're building is going to be placed. And it's basically a container, we'll say, for all of your objects and models that you'll be building. And then over here on the left side, which I've got my layout modified a little bit. Yours might look a little bit different, but the key parts that you want to focus on really are going to be this Explorer and Properties pane here. If for whatever reason you can't see those, head on up to your View tab and make sure that they're enabled here. So if I turn these off, you can see they go away. So just make sure that these two are enabled so that you can follow along with what we're doing and be able to manipulate your parts. So first thing, if we head over to the Model tab, you'll see we've got some various controls here, and this is for manipulating the parts. So first one is pretty self-explanatory. It's select, so it allows you to just select the parts. And then we have move, which again, following those X, Y, and Z axes, we're able to move the part around just by grabbing those arrows. And you can also grab the part itself, which just kind of slides it around on the top of whatever other part that it happens to be touching. In this case, it's the base plate. If we had other objects here, grabbing by the middle might lead to some sort of weird behavior because it's going to try to jump on top of other parts and rotate itself and stuff like that. So for more accuracy, you want to try to use these arrows to move around your scene. Then we have scale, and scale is going to give you the same color handles, but they're different handles. You see they're balls instead of arrows, and all that is just kind of lets you grab, hold, and drag, and resize, and things like that. And then we also have rotate. Again, you have the same color scheme, but now we have these circular arcs going around it, and what that allows you to do is move around in that axis and rotate the parts however you need to. Okay. And transform we'll get into a little bit later. It's a little bit less of a control that I use. In fact, I can't say that I ever actually use this particular control, but we will cover that in a later video. Over here in the second section here, we have some constraints, some snapping. So right now I have them turned off. And you can turn those on by checking them here. And what that does is it basically says, as you're moving or as you're rotating, snap to these measurements. So in this case, if I have scale, then as I start dragging it, it snaps one stud at a time. And I can change this to say 5. And you see it's a much bigger snap here. And same goes for the rotate, whereas before when that was unchecked, I could just kind of do whatever with it. With this checked, it's going to snap to, in this case, 45 degrees at a time. And you can see as I hover over the handle, there's some lines that appear that show you what those angles are. And you'll notice that if I lower this, you get much more lines. And so when you're rotating, it follows that guide and snaps to those values, which can really come in handy if you're trying to do some precise alignment, you know, things like that, building more complex models. Lastly, we have different types of parts that we can place as well. So you're not limited to just the block, right? So you can do a sphere, a wedge, or a cylinder. For right now, we're going to keep working with our block here, and we'll get into some of these other shapes a little bit later. Probably the next video, we'll start building more of a complex model and putting these different parts together and aligning them so you can see how it all goes together. Another very important thing to focus on here, the collisions. I like to work with collisions turned off. You'll find, and I'll show you an example here, if I drop another part, right, and let's go ahead and enlarge this one. Okay, now if I'm trying to move this part around, one thing that you're going to notice is, let me turn these off first of all, as I'm moving, so right now I have collisions off and I'm able to kind of place things however I want, but if I were to turn this on, now what you're going to notice happens is it's actually going to stop me. So it causes some unusual behavior sometimes if you have you know, some smaller parts scattered around or more complex models or anything like that, and you're trying to really get an accurate, you know, precise precision on things. This can cause some headaches. So I like to work with this turned off and just sort of rely on making sure that I'm placing things and building things as precisely as possible without relying on that. Just makes things a little bit easier. Another thing here too, these stud patterns that you see here, same as how you see on the base plate down here, you can turn those off. And I don't usually have any reason to keep them in this default. Unfortunately, there's no way to set the default. So to change those, just come down here to Surface, and you'll see the bottom surface and the top surface are the only two that don't follow the smooth setting that the other sides have. So to change that, all you have to do is just open this up and go to smooth. And in doing so, so now we have a smooth object without the Lego look to it. And that's most commonly what you're going to end up working with as you're doing the builds. There are some additional properties here that you can set that will change some of the behaviors of the way that they interact with each other, but again, that's another something that we'll go over in later videos. So for right now, those are your basics for placing an object and using some of the controls, and I think in our next video we'll start assembling a model and actually put something together that we can start using and scripting and things like that. So do me a favor and like and subscribe so we can keep these series going. The more visibility I get, like I said, the more videos I will produce. So go ahead and mash those buttons down there. Drop a comment if you'd like. Share it with your friends. And I'm looking forward to seeing you in future videos.